A confused online shopper is begging for help. Steve Morrow lives in New Zealand. The Australian website Stuff reports he came across an online farm auction Sunday. That auction included 1,000 hens for sale. Morrow won that auction, but he thought he had the option of only buying 20. No, he had to take all 1,000 hens. He is now pleading with people to take the rest. He said so far, he's found new homes for about 700 hens. See, these ladies here, they're helping out of school, so no hens will be involved here, so don't panic, everybody. We have the Shop and Grow Markets. They're gonna be opening 2 locations in schools. Here we have Julie Harden with Cigna, Meredith Kopp with St. Louis Area Food Bank. Let's go ahead and start with Rose Hanley with the Little Bit Foundation. You guys work with kids in school environments and everything from toiletries, books. What have you seen when you guys also focus on nutrition too?
Yeah, so many of our students, Little Bit is in 42 schools now, serving over 14,000 students. And when children are hungry, they have a hard time concentrating on their education. So we know that when their bellies are full, through this incredible partnership, they can concentrate on education. You know, academics go up, attendance goes up, mm-hmm. and discipline problems go down when children are fed healthy food.
The bottom line is you don't want anybody hangry, especially a child. We yes. have Meredith Kopp here with St. Louis Area Food Bank. We already heard that we definitely want to make sure that the kids are well fed regardless, but why do you feel the markets need to be inside a school?
Sure, so these Shop and Grow Markets and the great partnership with Cigna and the Little Bit Foundation is building on what we do at the St. Louis Area Food Bank, which is building stronger communities by empowering people with food and hope. These markets are going into Ashland and Yateman Liddell College Prep. These are areas that, according to Feed America, in St. Louis City have 23.3% of its residents that suffer from food insecurity. So they're not getting enough foods, the children or their families. That's 73,000 people and 14,000 are kids. These markets are going to bring healthy foods, nutritious foods to the kids during the day and the families throughout the weekend. And because of our great partnership with Cigna, yeah. there's no charge.
Oh, no charge. Okay, that was going to be my next question. No charge. Julie Harden with Cigna. Of course, no charge. How do the Shop and Grow Markets work? Do the parents give the kids the shopping list to say, hey, you're on your own, bro?
Yeah, no. So it's been a great collaboration, and we're really excited through the Cigna Foundation. We launched Healthier Kids for Our Future, which is a 5-year, $25 million investment to really improve the health and well-being of children. So we're super excited. The families have access to the markets a couple times a week. They can go in and just freely access the food. So it's been fantastic.
Let me go back to Meredith Knopp, sorry about that, St. Louis Area Food Bank. I know you guys take a lot of donations. What types of food donations are you all looking for specifically?
For things that kids would like. So we're looking for individual packs of cereal, of fruit cups, cheese sticks, anything that the kids can have grab and go for granola bars during the day. For the families, we're looking for those proteins. So your canned meats, your chicken, your tuna, your beef items that are there, pastas, ready to make meals. Because these families are going to be able to go in there and get milk, eggs, meats, proteins, everything they need for healthy and nutritious meals for their entire family. So anything that we can get is going to be wonderful for these families and our kiddos at Ashland and Yateman.
And Rose, do you feel like having opportunities like this will also educate kids in healthy food choices as they grow older?
Absolutely. So part of the partnership is teaching families nutrition information. So how to use the food and with recipes, how to eat as a family and bring everybody together in a beautiful celebration. So not only does it help with education, it builds strong communities.
That's right. And if you go into the markets, you'll see on billboards the nutritional information so that we can start to educate and really build awareness of paying attention to those numbers on the side of the box.
You've got to read those labels. You've got to teach kids how to read those labels. Okay, everybody, we are getting ready for a ribbon cutting, okay? We have, we have a ribbon cutting. Well, first, there will be one of the Shop and Grow Markets will be at the Yateman Liddell College Prep, but the ribbon cutting will be at Ashland Elementary. That's tomorrow at 9 in the morning, 3921 North Newstead. The littlebitfoundation.org will have more information, but just double checking, is the entire community invited to come out?
Oh, yes.
Sure. Absolutely.
The more the merrier. It's about community. Food is a natural uniter. Come out and celebrate.
Yeah. All right, everybody. Absolutely. We are going to go ahead and cater ourselves a great future here on the 9 a.m. show. Maybe I can start.